Welcome back, Tigers. In this video, we're going to learn how to add onto the button we created in a previous video. Our users need the ability to reassign related activities, opportunities, and contacts when they are changing account owners from the Accounts tab. Let's go check out how we can add this functionality to our Change Account Owner button. All right, here we are on the Accounts tab, and we're going to add some additional features into this Change Owner custom button that we created in a previous video. This button allows the user to change accounts from a list view in the Accounts tab and reassign them to a new owner. This button does not allow the user to choose if they want to reassign related contacts, open opportunities, or tasks and events. So we're going to add all of those features into this button. If you missed that video, go ahead and check it out in the description below. So we're going to go to the screen flow that is running that custom button. And we're going to add some additional fields up here to this first screen. So we're going to add 4 checkbox fields. This first one is called Reassign Contacts to New Owner, and none of these are required. Our second one is called Reassign Open Tasks to New Owner. Our third one is called Reassign Future Events to New Owner. And the fourth one will reassign open opportunities to the new owner. So when the user checks this box, we need to query the records that need to be reassigned to the new owner that they select in this field. Next, we're going to add a decision element right here. And this is going to check to see if the user checked the box to reassign the contacts to the new owner. We'll look for that checkbox to be true. And then if it's true, we want to query any contacts that are in any of the accounts that the user selected in the list view. So we're going to do a get records here. And we're going to look for all of the contacts with an account ID in our variable called IDs. And we're only going to look for one record. And then we're only going to let Salesforce choose the ID. This is going to make this process lighter in the event that you have hundreds of fields on the contact object. We really don't need any of those. We just need to get the ID. Then we're going to add another decision element. This is going to check to see if there are any related contacts. This will look at the get records for the contact. And we're just going to check to see if that is null. If it's not null, we're going to run an update to all of the contacts. We're going to look for all of the contacts with the account ID in our IDs collection. And we're going to update the owner ID to be the value that the user selected in the screen flow, which is right here, choose new account owner. And then we're gonna choose the ID. And then all of the other checkboxes are gonna follow this exact same path. We're gonna have a decision, a get records, another decision, and an update. We will check to see if the user checked this box. If they did check the box, we're going to do a get records. We're going to do a get records on the task object, and your criteria may be a little bit different. You may want to look for different dates. You may want to look for different statuses. We're going to look for the account ID to be in our IDs. I want to explain a little bit here about why I'm doing that. Now, there's a cool feature, kind of a secret feature about tasks, that if you have a task related to an opportunity or related to a contact via the what ID or who ID, this account ID is automatically going to be populated. So I really like to use the account ID rather than looking for the related to, because if the user has a task related to the opportunity, then this process isn't going to pick that up. So whenever I'm looking for tasks related to an account, I always use this little secret field called account ID. We're going to look for tasks with the account ID in our text collection there. And then we only want to reassign the tasks that are currently open. So I'm going to put a filter in here that looks for the tasks that are not currently completed. I'm also going to choose the fields that I want it to query, and because I only need the ID to keep this process nice and light. I'm then going to check to see if there are any open tasks that need to be reassigned. And then if there are, we're going to run an update to those tasks. I'm going to look for the tasks that have an account ID in my IDs, in my status is not equal to completed. And then I'm going to reassign those to the new account owner. I'm going to save this so I don't lose anything here. Now we need to work on our future events. So we'll check to see if the user checked that box. Then we're going to do a get records on the event object. We're going to use the same criteria that we use for tasks. Our account ID is in our IDs collection. And then we're going to look for the start date to be in the future. So we're going to look for it to be greater than tomorrow. Your criteria can be whatever you want. So we'll go ahead and create a formula field that shows tomorrow's date. And then we only need the ID, so we'll select choose fields and let Salesforce do the rest. We'll add another decision here to see if any future events were found. And then if they were found, we're going to reassign them. So we're going to do an update here. We're going to look for the account ID to be in our text collection and the start date time to be in the future. Then we're going to run an update to the owner to be the new owner that the user selected in the screen flow. Our last one is our opportunities. We're going to check to see if the user checked that box. And then if they did check that box, we're going to find the open opportunities. We're going to see if any exists. We're going to look for the account ID to be in our text collection. And then we're going to look for it to be open. Rather than looking for stage values, I always like to use the is closed field, because that way if stages change or they get added, we don't ever have to come into this flow and make any updates, because it's always going to be filtering for open opportunities. Then we're going to choose fields because we only need the ID there. Then we're going to check to see if there were any open opportunities that needed to be reassigned. And then if we do have opportunities that exist, we're going to run an update. We're going to look for all the open opportunities that are related to accounts in our text collection. And then they are closed. And then we'll just update the owner. Now there could be a lot that goes wrong with this flow. So we actually want to make sure that we add in some fault paths here to provide a message to the user in the event that something does go wrong. So we're going to go ahead and add a fault path to each of these updates. We're going to add a screen here. We're going to add a display text. And this is the text that I want to display. So you get this flow fault message here by going to your resources, typing in flow, and selecting fault message. So this is going to contain the error that is causing the problem. So we'll click done there. And now after every update, we can connect it to that same error screen. So we'll add a fault path, and then we'll connect it to our screen down here. Okay, we've got those all connected. Now, another thing you may want to do is add some display text to this success screen so that it displays if there were records that were reassigned. I'm going to move this link down to another display text. You'll see why here in a second. And then this first one is going to be for contacts. So contacts were reassigned to, and then you can get the name of the new owner right here. And then we can copy this and we can just use it for all of the others and just switch out the object at the beginning. And now we're going to do some show hide conditional visibility. So we only want to show if contacts were reassigned, if the user checked that box on the screen at the beginning. So if reassign contacts to new owner under screen components is true, we want to show that message. Then for tasks, we're going to do the same thing and look for the task checkbox. We want the screen component. Make sure you choose the checkbox under the screen component here. We're going to reassign future events. We'll select that. And if that's true, we want to show this message. And then the last one is our opportunities. Okay, our success screen is all set. We'll click save there. We are going to update our description because it's very important that we have all our descriptions up to date in our flows. We're going to activate. And now we're finally ready to test this out. All right, we're going to hop over to our accounts tab and we're going to look at all of our accounts, and we can see right now that they're all assigned to Blue Tiger Academy. Now we also have an account record here that we have loaded up over 200 contacts because we really wanted to stress test our flow. So we can see here that we've got 262 contacts all owned by Blue Tiger Academy. We also have loaded in over 200 tasks and over 200 events to make sure that those all get reassigned without throwing any errors. And then we've got some opportunities in here. We also have some closed opportunities in this list that we want to make sure are not reassigned. So all of these right here should stay assigned to Blue Tiger Academy and Lila Pouncer. Now we're going to use our change owner button to change all of the accounts from Blue Tiger Academy over to me. So let's go ahead and check this box. Let's click change owner. I'm going to search for me, and then I'll check all these boxes to reassign all the related records. Yay, they were all reassigned. Okay, we're going to return to our accounts tab. Now let's check and make sure they really were assigned. So if I go to all accounts, I expect all of the accounts to be owned by me, which is correct. That's great. Now let's go to our super account that has tons of stuff. So we can see the activities here. They no longer say Blue Tiger Academy. They say they're assigned to me. So there's over 200 of each. So the flow is able to handle all of that, which is awesome. If I go to my contacts, I should see that they're all assigned to me as well. I'll refresh that. When we were testing, we saw that we had to refresh this sometimes. All right, all those records look great. Now let's make sure only our open opportunities got reassigned. So beautiful. We can see here that the closed one ones are, let me refresh. There we go. We can see that the closed one and closed lost are still assigned to Blue Tiger Academy and Lila, but all these up here that have open stages, these are still open. Those are assigned to me now. So our flow is working perfectly, even with hundreds of records to reassign. That's it. That's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on our next video that will show you how to get the most out of a Salesforce feature called Account Intelligence View. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you'd like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.